Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Okay, my name is Chin Yong. So this session will be about sense and sensibility. So this is actually the second run I have in Barcamp. So this was presented first in Barcamp 5 back in 2010. Okay, so if anyone who's been through this, I suggest you to go to next door. Okay. Else, I'll just proceed. Okay. So some background, my name is Chin Yong. Currently, I'm the engineering manager at Viki. So the reason why I even came up with this topic is that back in my university days in NTU, so me and a couple of friends, we co-founded this NTU Wine Appreciation Club. Okay, that's where I get exposed to, you know, the appreciation of wine. And from there, I've sort of like developed this sense of smelling stuff. And hence, I also have this theory that our sense have a certain limitation. Okay, so along the session, I will just explain to y'all what does it mean. Okay. So, first of all, aromas can offer a lot of bandwidth. Okay, so I will go through the details in bandwidth. So, however, this session there will be a certain bit of exercise that I need all of you to do. So, what I have here is actually a very simple scent kit. So, the scent kit, what you do is just unscrew it. Okay, take a sniff, and you will have this very distinct scent of what this particular item be. It can be a fruit, or it can be anything else. Okay. So what I'll do here is that I'll pass it down the rows. Just take a sniff and pass it to the next person beside you and go it down, and it should end up at my wife behind. Okay. So yeah, here you go. Okay. So when you take a sniff, okay, try to remember what smell is it. Okay, don't tell anyone. Just keep it in your head. Okay. So for this, just take a sniff, or don't put your finger whatsoever. Okay. So Lisa, let's just go around or proceed with the presentation. So example of bandwidth, okay, just so happened that we have a false alarm for fire drill. So typically, in terms of scent, most of the time you smell the smoke before you feel the heat. Okay, this is one example of those. Secondly is that similarly, if you step on dog poop or anything like that, you will smell it first before you even see the bottom of your feet. Okay. Then next, if you break it down, scent is actually a chemical compound that has a smell or odor, and this is something like a simple compound that has a particular scent. Okay, so typically these compounds are slightly volatile in the sense that they dissolve in water or any solvent, and they can be captured in air molecules in the air. Okay, so I think we've got two more parties. Okay. So let them finish first, then I will ask the question. Okay, so currently in this crowd, anyone want to give a good guess of what particular scent is that?
Grass?
Lemongrass. Okay. Any other suggestions?
Yeah, it's like lemon.
Mix.
Lemongrass. A little more lemony.
So someone says citrus, okay?
Citrus,
yeah. Okay, citrus, lemongrass. Okay, so... Okay, so... Any
grapefruit?
Okay, anyone else? Okay, so we are very close. So the actual scent in the particular bottle is lemon, actually. Okay, so lemongrass, which is very similar, okay? So... another thing is that for us, we don't really like smell lemon per se. Our concept of lemon is actually more or less corrupted by cleaning agent, you know, detergent, washing powders. Okay. So next, I have another small bottle. Okay. So we'll go through the same exercise. Okay. There you go.
Do you have coffee beans or something?
No, I don't have coffee beans, unfortunately. Okay. So this is the key part of the of my sharing. So, scent is actually a highly experiential concept. Okay, it's much like taste and touch, where it still remains in the domain of analog. You know, technology has not advanced sufficient enough for us to capture it in a digital form. Okay, so how I would say is that, for example, let me give you an example. When we talk about, think of something rough, okay? Something rough, okay? Can you give me an example of what is rough to you? The last time you touched something rough?
Like
sandpaper, okay? So when we talk about sandpaper, do you visualize sandpaper or you visualize yourself touching sandpaper? Sorry?
Visualize the sandpaper.
Okay. Material itself, okay? So you visualize it, okay? Do you sort of like record the sound of you touching sandpaper? Right. So what I'm trying to say here is that most of our experience in life are actually very visual, number one, followed by audio. Okay. So scent is actually not the primary source of recalling of experience. So which is one of but scent is actually very interesting and it offers us an extra dimension of stuff. Okay. So that's why I say, you know, this is what sort of intrigued me to a certain extent. Okay. So also this also come to the point where what I mean by vocabulary overmind mapping. So what happens is that if I tell you that this particular object smells like so and so, you can quickly recall that, okay, I can remember the smell. However, if I give you a scent and ask you to map it to the particular word, we have more difficulty doing that. Okay, the inverse is not true. Right? For example, if I tell you like imagine the smell of coffee. Okay, more or less everyone of us has a small impression of how the coffee smells like. Okay, but however, if I give you a particular object like that, so for example, the last scent you have, anyone want to offend them, I guess?
Yeah,
vanilla? Anyone else?
What
was that? What? His answer was vanilla.
It smells like varnish.
Okay, anyone want to offend them, I guess? So,
redwood.
Okay. So, can I say that is the scent pleasant or not? Is it pleasant?
Neutral.
It
was not burning off. It was not.
Okay. Is it familiar?
Yeah, it feels
familiar. It smells like rubbish dump.
Okay. So, for that, this gentleman is correct. It's actually vanilla. Okay. So, a lot of times you will smell something, it's very familiar, but we can't pinpoint what's the actual word for that. And that requires some, you know, some, I won't say practice, but more mindfulness when you try to appreciate stuff. Okay, so again, today we have 4 bottles. If we are fast, we may finish 5 bottles, 5 of these, okay? Okay. Okay. No,
quick question about this. Does the scent deteriorate over time even though they are stored in bottles?
So these are synthetic. So if I don't expose them to the sun or expose them and put in a bottle, they should remain very consistent.
For how long?
I do not know. Huh? I don't see any expiry date on this particular
one.
Okay. So this particular kit I have is actually a wine scent kit. So in any good wine shop, they will actually have this. This is for those who are into the wine business, especially sommeliers or wine waitress. They will try to understand what does this smell mean so that they can help them to describe wine better and stuff like that. So it is a training kit mainly for the F&B sector.
Okay.
Okay, I just have fortunate enough to get my hands on one set. Okay. So this scene is actually from Ratatouille. If you remember that cartoon long time ago. Okay. Okay, so very simple, back to day-to-day. So all these are fried food. Okay, and I believe most of you can easily identify that McDonald's smells different from KFC and smells different from Long John.
Yeah.
Right? You walk past, you smell it, okay, this is McDonald's. How does McDonald's smell like? Okay, so McDonald's has this very...
MSG feeling.
MSG feeling. MSG feeling, correct?
MSG doesn't smell, but you can relate like your MSG, like very artificial feeling.
I'll classify as this like junk food smell.
It smells like
heart attack. Okay. KFC has this more of a sesame based kind of scent. Okay. That's my impression. Okay. And Long John Silver has this very I wouldn't say fishy, like the oil that's been overused. Some of that these are the scents I gather, okay? But distinctly, each of them is distinct, right? Even though all of them smell like fried food, okay? Next, bring closer to home, most of us like coffee here. So, Yakun has a very distinct smell from the rest, when you walk past the shop, you know this is Ya Kun. Okay, fairly distinct. Okay, but however, coffee bean has actually very subtle scent. When you walk past it, you might not know it's coffee bean. And but Starbucks has this very sweet, sickening sweet frappe scent. It's like syrup and coffee.
The Starbucks does artificially aromatize its stores, right? So they have an aroma releaser that actually releases the smell of coffee, which would attract people looking at the coffee.
Oh, I'm not aware of that.
Yeah. So they have a special kind of small thing. And someone, the one at City Hall had it, so the one nearby, they have one of those sprays.
Sprays. Okay. So I believe everyone finished the last bottle, correct? Any takers for that?
Apple.
Rose. Apple.
Really?
Yeah. Anyone else?
I got rose.
No rose. Okay. So maybe to classify, what does it smell like? I mean, is it pleasant?
Sweet.
Maybe sweetest, okay. Is it something that you edible?
To me, it felt like apples.
Okay.
Grapes.
Okay. So, is the, that particular scent belongs to the berry family? So it's actually not very common. So it's actually a raspberry.
Oh,
it's berry.
Oh, you walk part time. It seems to get on here, right?
Yeah. Right. So, the berries is actually very complex. Different berries have different scents. Okay. So. Let me try this again. Okay, this one should be.
Sorry, just one question while you're doing check. As you if sense, you know, as you say that touch and hearing are the primary sense.
No, visual and hearing.
So, how can we use scent for our advantage nowadays? Apart from seducing the opposite sex.
I wouldn't say advantage. I would say that okay.
How can we make full use of it?
Since it's very subtle, I won't say it's subtle. It's actually very in your face. Scent is actually in your face. For example, if you try durian, it's actually in your face. You feel it.
Yeah, of course. So the sweat, like those, I've seen
an
MRT people staying away from me, definitely.
Right. So what I'm trying to say is that, because of maybe like more of us are like work in the tech sector or something like that, we are more exposed to things that can be digitized, right? Which is audio and visual, right? With that, our experience with life is mainly through audio and visual, okay. And we sort of, I won't say we sort of like does not experience life or what we have via the scent more than we should, than we can. Okay, there's no such thing as more advantageous to us. It's wherever how you, there's a dimension that I think we could better explore, so that you know, we have a sort of more, less digital and more analog.
Have you watched the movie Perfume?
No.
You should watch that movie.
Okay.
But there's a movie. I watched it like 8 years ago. It was about taking scent of people and using it.
Yeah. Okay. So similarly for scent, there are some scent that we like babies. Okay. Babies have this.
What is vomit smell?
For babies, I get a couple of classification. So vomit smell is one. Then the other one is taking powder. Yeah. Okay, so taking powder, and the other one is tiger balm.
That's in Asia.
That's in Asia, right? So these are three scents that typically people feedback to me. Okay. Then last, of course, there are people who like the scent when before the rain and after the rain. So sometimes I found there's actually a word for that. Okay. And are we done with the last bottle, everyone? Okay, so pleasant or not pleasant?
Pleasant.
Pleasant. This is sweet, right?
I think I need
Okay. Anyone want to fandom a guess?
Strawberries.
Anyone else?
Definitely not durian.
The French don't have durians. Okay, this kid is actually from France.
Oh,
okay.
Wow.
Okay. So this gentleman is right again. So it's strawberry.
Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
Wow.
Should be on a game show.
Okay. So some people just has a sharper sense of smell or their recall is better. Okay. So last, okay, this is the tough one. Okay. Yeah. Okay. You're an F&B? What do you work as?
Food tech.
Food tech? Okay. So do you do... So what kind of food tech are you in?
Bakery.
Bread. Bakery. Bakery bread. Okay. So you are exposed to...
Vanilla essence.
Sure. Okay. That explains. Okay. So this is this guy is imbalance in bar. Okay. So you cannot compare. Okay. So generally, I can't differentiate the smell of flowers, unfortunately, because there's just too many of them. Okay. But the obvious one like roses, we know. Okay. But beyond that, I can't differentiate as well. And of course, being in Singapore, we are blessed with a lot of access to a lot of different kinds of tropical fruits. Okay, so very quickly, if I tell you pineapple, you all can recall the smell, right? Okay, I'm not going to say pen, because. Okay, dragon fruit. What does it smell like? Okay, dragon fruit is technically quite scentless, unless you get the purple one. Okay, the purple one has this very leafy smell. Okay, then. If I'm not wrong, let's hope that this is guava. Guava is actually very similar to 100 plus. Okay, if I'm not wrong, 100 plus is actually the taste of guava, or sour, I think it's guava. Then if I tell you mango, most of us will be able to recall the scent, the scent of mango. How about star fruits? Okay. So, if I tell you that this fruit, you all can recall the smell. However, if I blind you, you might not be able to get it. So this, I say the inverse mapping is flawed in a sense. Okay. Then, okay. Last but not least, this is chicken rice. So how does chicken rice?
You
don't
have chili sauce.
So for chicken rice, okay, what's the dominant scent in chicken rice?
Lemongrass.
The dominant scent in
chicken rice. Yeah, because
with
the chicken rice, the fragrance,
you
actually put the lemongrass to
put
the chicken.
Is it lemongrass or pandan?
Pandan.
Both,
right?
Both.
Pandan,
right? Okay. So the interesting about this is that depending on the different parts, it's a different scent. Okay. So this will bring to the next question is that when the last time you have your, let's say, char kway teow or something like that, do you sniff it before you eat it?
Yes.
Yes, okay. That's good. Okay. So what I'm trying to encourage is that you should be doing that. Right. So because we have access to a lot of good food, different cuisine. Okay. It's a pity that we don't appreciate it before we eat it. Okay, that's what I'm trying to share. Okay. So the last item, last bottle. Anyone want to give a guess?
It's very strong that we mask up the entire smell.
So is it pleasant? Sorry, it's tea, okay?
It's like the smell after you leave Zoom.
It's a pungent, sharp smell.
Mm-hmm. But this is something that we have almost every day.
Oh.
Almost every day.
Let's go to this chicken rice
picture. No, nothing to do it. Okay. So let's say in the morning you wake up, you will have jam and what's the other thing?
Bread.
What do you put on bread?
Butter.
That's actually the smell of butter.
Butter.
Yes.
Oh.
Okay.
That's butter.
Yeah. Oh, wow. So this proves that everyone morning wake up butter spread. You don't smell.
Is it just because it's not like? Is it just me? When you heat the butter, I guess does it smell different than this?
So typically when you heat the butter, you will get that buttery smell. So that is around the scent. But it's definitely not as strong. Because once you heat the butter, it becomes volatile. It's a very strong, the scent is very pronounced. Okay, so that one is butter. And last but not least, okay, thank you for your attention. And I hope you use your nose more. That's my Twitter handle. I don't update it that much. And I didn't play my background song, so sorry for that. Okay, and that's about it. Any question?
And then it's not just about F&B, like
Starbucks or McDonald's, they build their unique like scents.
Yes.
Like, recognizable. Like, what I notice is that Timberland, they have the scent in their stores that coming from the aircon or something. Mm-hmm. It's a very signature one that I really notice. I like it, so I notice. But it also helps you like build your brand equity or your build character.
Right.
It's something that you will remember. In a way, the character of the scent is also kind of your brand equity.
Right.
So that's what I noticed when you just mentioned about
it. So on a similar note, I have a friend who works in sort of like helping in like companies to do branding. So his understanding is that some of the clothing stores, in the morning, they actually, even the others, they sort of like spray this particular liquid on their clothes. So this is to degrease them so that the white shirt doesn't turn yellow because of a customer touching them, right? And with that, they will also carry a particular scent. So that if you walk to like a different store, like three female stores, like Forever 21 or some other one, each of them have a distinct smell compared to the others. Okay, I'm not sure, is it on purpose or is it just that the particular degreasing mist which the spray has that carry the smell?
Some of them do it on purpose. There is a whole like of industry that's spawned out of how to like build brand recall by using scent.
Mm-hmm.
So they use all these. Even Bill Gates is spending a lot of money now on scent.
Mm-hmm.
So one of his learnings was that people, when they try to build toilets, especially in India, people are not using them because it stinks.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're developing a scent that will sanitize, not sanitize, but basically mask the smell of shed to your nose, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what they're doing is that they can't... there's some side effect term hole behind it, I can't remember. Essentially, they'll spray that and then it will mask the smell. It will not alter because a lot of tech currently in urinals and stuff use an additive agent.
Okay.
They are trying to change it by saying, okay, we'll just mask it. So we'll not mask it, we'll block it. So you can't smell shit. And then that might get more people to use the product. It was very interesting. I was like,
Okay, so any other questions? I hope you enjoy the session. Okay, so I think that's all. Yes.
Your day job is...
No, I'm a software engineer.
Yeah, like, do you apply some of this stuff in Viki? Because Viki is the drama source, is it?
Yes, correct.
So then you...
This is just my personal interest. It's not related to my work.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.